A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 29th July, on the front page you have Karnataka speaker disqualifies 14 more MLAs before trust vote. So this is further development in Karnataka Legislative Assembly. The coalition government lost its majority, but the speaker is still deciding on 14 rebel MLAs. So they had submitted their resignation too, and there are disqualification proceedings also going on against them. So disqualifications on charges of defection under 10th schedule of the Indian Constitution. So now the speaker has taken decision on these 14 rebel MLAs and has disqualified them as such. So the total number of disqualified MLAs is 17 in the present Karnataka Legislative Assembly. So you can see the strength in the house. There are 208 members now. Of the 225 MLAs, you can see 17 are disqualified, so there are 208 members, and out of these 208, BJP has 105 members. So, for majority, it requires 105, which it has. Then this is, government must convince industry of RCEP's benefits, Australia. So this is regarding RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So this is actually a free trade agreement we negotiated amongst 15 nations. So it's a 15 member free trade agreement being negotiated. The 15 members are 10 ASEAN members, Association of Southeast Asian members, plus the other members which have free trade agreement with Asia. So here you can see India is also it wants India to commit to the deal by the end of this year. So that is why Australia and various other countries have come together. So Australia is also part of this RCEP. China, Australia, New Zealand, Japan, and India, South Korea are member of this RCEP. So they are negotiating the deal. So Australia is leading the diplomats from various countries. So all countries want India to commit to the deal because India has raised its concerns with respect to RCEP because it is considered as a backdoor entry for China, because all other countries in RCEP have a free trade agreement with China except India. So if RCEP involves China as well, India has concerns that it will become a backdoor entry for cheap Chinese imports entering into India. So that is why India has raised its concerns. It has also raised concerns that it wants more accessibility to Indian services in RCEP. So you can see here the concerns are there. See, serious concerns are worries over flooding of the market with Chinese goods and lack of access for Indian services in the RCEP countries. You can see RCEP countries are mentioned here, 10 nation ASEAN and its 5 FTA partners, India, China, Japan, Australia and New Zealand. So it's a 15 member group. So the news is that Australia is leading the diplomats from various countries. All diplomats from all the countries of RCEP have come together and they want India to commit to the deal by the end of year 2019. So Australia is leading the diplomats. And you can see the Australian envoy has also said that the agreement would be beneficial for India and government must convince the industry of RCEP's benefits. Then this is, Naga register will shield state from outsiders, says Deputy CM. So this is regarding RIN exercise. So it continued to be in news for some time. You can see Regional Comprehensive RIN is a register of indigenous inhabitants of Nagaland. The Deputy CM of Nagaland says that we are consulting civil groups and NSC and IM as such on the issue. So NSC and IM are civil society groups in Nagaland. That's what he said. Then below you have security tightened in Jammu and Kashmir. So a huge number of security officials have been deployed in Jammu and Kashmir, and enhancement of security grid and fresh orders to local officials continued in Jammu and Kashmir further too. So it is said by the political parties here that top government says that it is a routine contingency augmentation to counter any rise in militant attack, but regional parties term the measures as a hint at tinkering with the state's special status. On page 5 you have religious functions banned on roads banned in Aligarh. So the Aligarh administration has put a blanket ban on holding religious functions on roads. So the decision came after some Hindutva groups planned the recital of Hanuman Chalisa to protest against offering of namaz on roads. So this administration had taken this step as a precautionary measure to prevent any disturbance. And you can see the district magistrate of Aligarh was warned against going ahead with this order of banning the recital of Hanuman Chalisa. So video clip has also gone viral on this warning by a Hindutva group leader. On page 7 you have cybercrime officials suspect Agent Smith targets Indians. So investigations show 59% of those affected are from India. So Indian cybercrime officials tracking the recently detected Agent Smith malware believe it is targeted at Indians, who constitute the highest number of victims so far. So here you can see this is Agent Smith, which is believed to have infected 25 million devices so far. It was first noticed early in 2019. The malware can replace apps on Android phones with malicious versions without the user's knowledge. So this is said to be an advanced malware, and it is said to be using all the latest vulnerabilities in the Android operating system, and it has been designed specifically to exploit them. One such vulnerability is being spoken of. It is called Janus, so which was discovered by cybersecurity researchers in 2017. This is a vulnerability of a weak point in the Android operating system of Google. So here you can see Agent Smith. Presently what it is doing is it is putting in targeted advertisements. So here you can say at the moment seems to be limited to throwing up targeted advertisements, but then it can be more harmful too. On page 8 you have bumpy road for colistin ban rollout. So Kerala government is being spoken of here, but the Union Health Ministry has actually banned manufacture, sale and distribution of the antibiotic colistin and its formulations for food producing animals, poultry, aqua farming and animal feed supplements. So the ban is expected to combat antimicrobial resistance in the country. So indiscriminate use of antibiotics in animal husbandry sector, especially use of colistin for non-therapeutic purposes in poultry farming, because it results in better growth rather than, you know, for some disease as an antibiotic. It is used in poultry, in animal husbandry industry for better growth. So this is being banned by the country now. But then there is huge colistin import coming from China, which may be reaching poultry farms. So that is a concern being flagged. On page 9 you have audit report reveals irregularities within scam hit Vyapam. So this is regarding Vyapam scam, which is Madhya Pradesh, you know, entrance exam scam for jobs as such too, an examination board. So it has been a full-fledged scam which has been unveiled now. So recruitments were carried out during 2 years under false premises. So here it is said for at least 2 financial years after Vyapam scam was uncovered in Madhya Pradesh in 2013, administrative and financial irregularities running in crores of rupees continued unchecked within the examination board. Means even after Vyapam scam was unveiled, was uncovered and investigation started in 2013, irregularities continued for 2 more years. So there are glaring irregularities just such as unjustified recruitment of volunteers, posting of security guards hired by Vyapam at private bungalows, recruitment of officials on fake community certificates, and use of whitener and overwriting in cash books. So all this has come out now. So you should know about the Vyapam scam of 2013 in Madhya Pradesh. So it's an examination board, state examination board. It's Vyapam is the short form in Hindi. In English, the name is Madhya Pradesh Professional Examination Board. It's for recruitment. It was a board, examination board for recruitment of government, recruitment to government jobs and admissions to educational institutions in Madhya Pradesh. And it's a scam in which huge number of people are involved. There have been many names, big names of ministers as such too, former ministers of education from Madhya Pradesh, which have also been booked under the Vyapam scam. There have been many deaths which have been seen in this scam. Many accused, many other people associated with it have been killed and the mysterious circumstances too, in accidents, etc. So such unnatural deaths have also been seen in which is related to this case. Then this is Himalayan states demand green bonus. So Himalayan states came together at a conclave and demanded a separate ministry to deal with the problems which are endemic to them, and also demanded a green bonus in recognition of their contribution to environmental conservation. So here you can see they said most of the country's rivers originate in Himalayas, and therefore Himalayan states play a most significant role in the water conservation initiative of the Prime Minister too, and they have to be given a green bonus. But they are at a disadvantage too because of large amount of land falling in eco-sensitive zones where other developmental activities cannot be carried out. So that is why they want this green bonus. Then next is Army's first integrated battle groups to be structured by end of next month. So a new concept of integrated battle groups is what the Army plans to create as part of its overall force transformation. So this is going to be implemented, and it is said that integrated battle groups will be brigade sized, agile and self-sufficient combat formations which can swiftly launch strike against adversaries in case of hostilities. So this concept has already been tested, you know, and now it will be put into effect. So reorganization based on feedback will be done now of these integrated battle groups, which are detailed out here, you can see. Each of them is tailor-made based on threat, terrain and task. And resources will be allotted based on these three T's for the integrated battle groups. And they'll be able to mobilize within 12 to 48 hours based on the location. And Army is going to approach the center for sanction for this. Then below you have need to help boys disclose sexual abuse, says activists. So this is the National Crime Records Bureau, which will for the first time collect gender disaggregated data on sexual assaults against children. So it says that for this to be successful, the activists say a lot will have to be done to ensure boys or transgender children open up about sexual abuse. So sexual abuse amongst boys is now an issue. It was during the passage of the POXO Amendment Act of 2019 in the House, in the Parliament. MP Derek O'Brien, he spoke about how at the age of 13 in a public bus he was, he faced such sexual abuse. Someone ejaculated on his shorts, and he said he did not talk about the incident for 6 to 7 years before finally telling his parents. So, and he said that he still recollects that incident, which shows the impact which it had on him as such. So this such issues, such incidents, happen, and there is a need for kids to speak it out in the open and to address these issues. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is sexism in parliament. So this is regarding the recent incident which has been prominently in news regarding Samajwadi Party MP Azam Khan. So he had addressed the sitting chair of Lok Sabha. It was BJP member Rama Devi who was in the chair as such, and he referred to her in an inappropriate way. Actually, he had quoted a couplet to idhar udhar ki baat na kar, and he was speaking as such in the triple talaq discussion on the triple talaq bill. And the chair Rama Devi, she said to him to look at her and talk, and on this he responded saying that he liked her so much that he can look in her eyes all the time as such. So he made such a statement, which is considered a sexist remark, and that is why there has been protests going on and BJP leaders demanding his resignation as such too, and ban on him. So this article actually talks of how India needs more women in legislatures to combat the likes of Azam Khan. So the women representation in the house is quite low. The 17th Lok Sabha, it is said, has the highest number of women MPs so far at 78, which is only 14.39% of the total strength of the house. So we have a long way to go, and a case has been made for that. And this is ban or regulate. So this is a question on cryptocurrencies. So there are issues with cryptocurrencies, but then it is said a ban might not be the best answer. So an interministerial committee of as such has been set up in India, and recommendation of this committee is that India should ban all private cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and others. So this is going to have consequences. So that is a suggestion by this committee. The decision has to be taken by the government. Then next is the lead article, Governing India through fiscal math. So it says a focus on fiscal deficit reduction alone is not sound economic management. The revenue deficit must be in the picture too. So what Indian government is looking at presently is to tackle the fiscal deficit, to achieve or to maintain the fiscal deficit target. But the revenue deficit is being lost in this, which is also important, which is highlighted here. So that is the deficit in revenue receipts and revenue expenditure. The Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act, FRBM Act, called for eventually reducing revenue deficit to zero. And fiscal deficit should be remaining at a low percentage. So that also has to be highlighted is what this article talks of. And this is history and the 5G dilemma. So this is as India looks at developing 5G technology. Its quest in the 1980s for an American supercomputer offers lessons. So the history about how India made a quest in 1980s for American supercomputers. So that is being spoken of here. On the op-ed page you have, it's time for India and Pakistan to walk the talk. So it says, given the various breaches, the Shimla agreement could do with a makeover. So India and Pakistan have to look into how the further development in ties can take place, and Shimla agreement can be revamped and put into effect for further enhancement of relations and resolution of conflict. Then this is respecting reproductive choice. So this says regulation of commercial surrogacy rather than a blanket ban may be the way forward. So this is regarding Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019, which has been approved by the cabinet. It bans and criminalizes commercial surrogacy and only allows altruistic surrogacy. And the conditions are so stringent. So we see that it may make surrogacy difficult. So that's what it says. This article says that regulation of commercial surrogacy is important rather than a blanket ban on it. Then on page 12, you have Vishakha rules must apply to judiciary. So this is former Chief Justice of Delhi High Court, Justice AP Shah, who says that there is a need to discuss how Vishakha guidelines, which are Supreme Court guidelines in Vishakha case, which deal with sexual harassment in workplace. So he says that there is a need for a discussion how these Vishakha guidelines will be applicable to judiciary, and they should be made applicable to judiciary. So this is in the context of, you know, sexual harassment charges against the Chief Justice of India, Justice Ranjan Gogoi. So a former Supreme Court employee made these sexual harassment allegations against him, a Supreme Court employee as such. On page 13, you have conflicting views pervade BRICS ministers meeting. So this is regarding how fight against terrorism, cooperation in areas of economy and people-to-people exchanges, which were the prominent themes in the one-day meeting of BRICS ministers, which took place in Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. So here you can see BRICS foreign ministers meeting took place on which issues were discussed. But then conflicting views have emerged. You can see. So there were diametrically opposite views taken on Venezuela as such too. So you can see. Russian foreign minister and policy veteran, he spoke on Venezuela taking a completely opposite view of others. So he said that we need to use international law as the basis for reaching a solution by themselves without outside intervention. Venezuela should be left on its own. So such diverging views have also come forth, you can see. So they all called upon BRICS nations to cooperate on combating terrorism. So BRICS Working Group on Counterterrorism is already in place to look into the matter too. Then below you have industry cautious on RCEP deal. So this is continuation of the front page news about how Indian industry has concerns with respect to RCEP, as we discussed on the front page. And this is three civilians injured as Pakistan violates ceasefire along LOC in Pooch. So this is the line of control, and here the ceasefire violation took place in which three civilians were injured on India's side. Then on international page, there's continuation of the same news. These are terror attacks in Afghanistan. Then these are how black lawmakers are being targeted, parliamentarians are being targeted in USA, and such racist attacks are taking place on them. And this is regarding Afghan government and Taliban talks, which we have discussed earlier. and this is regarding Iran as such in the Gulf region, how the tension is escalating with its standoff with Britain too. So now European fleet is being proposed to be present in the Gulf, which it opposes. And this is regarding Hong Kong protests also, how they have been rallying to Beijing office now. So all these news items we have covered earlier, so we don't need to cover every day's update on them. If there's significant update, then that will be covered in the news in future dates. Then also on business page, there's no important news. Also on the last page, you have sports coverage. So these were the important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for today. For PDF for current affairs, you can visit our website www.asha.com. Thank you.